Hello, boys and girls. In this video, I wanted to come back actually to Lie algebras. Now that in the last week, I talked over an hour about representations of general Lie algebras over general fields, and we have some hands-on objects where we can reflect on theorems as they will be found in this book. I thought I start with the basic definitions here, but as comes up like on the first page, there is this, let's not look at fields of characteristic 2 lingering around. And as this comes up often and will come up in other videos that I will make, I thought I'd make a short video about this topic, this subject, on individual basis. So as we will, I will just go through a bunch of Wikipedia pages again in this video and show you some definitions and then some notes. This is going to be quite basic, but I want to have these kind of videos that I can refer back to if people ask, hey, what do you mean by let's not look at fields of characteristic 2. So for a light starter, if you don't know, there is this, I don't know, by now 12, probably older, years old video where this kind of American university group of a cappella singers sing about the finite simple group of order 2. So that is the field with 2 elements. You can represent it as 0 and 1 and addition modulo 2. And they have this nice like romance song about it. I really like if people put in some effort. And this, there are a bunch of math songs on YouTube. Maybe I do a video eventually on the about the ones I like. Online, but that is really cute. So this is a soft related starter. So we're going to talk about characteristic 2 that works for rings. But in this video, you know, since I'm for Lie algebras, I'm interested in vector spaces over field and not some general modules over rings. I will talk about fields. So you can look at this page. You have the basic axioms, the important, you know, I usually think of you can think of fields as generalization of rational numbers, a very broad generalization. Difference to rings is you can divide nicely. And we are especially interested in finite fields in this video. So the important definition is, as this Wikipedia page says, the characteristic of a ring in that case is defined to be the smallest number of times that you must use the ring's multiplicative identity, so 1, to sum to the additive identity 0. So how many times do you have to add 1, 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 to get 0? So if you are in modular arithmetic, right, so if you look at the ring of integer modulo 7, then if you add 7 ones together, you are at 0. So this has characteristic of 7. And the characteristic of 2 is very special in the sense that if you add 1 plus 1 together, you already get 0. And the message here is really that the problem is that this doesn't even, if you have a field of characteristic 2, then you cannot even divide by 2, because 2 is 0, and you can't divide by 0. So a bunch of equations that you would want to work with are super trivial. Whenever in the formula it says 2x, then this is actually 0, and so everything breaks down. And so, you know, every characteristic is of course special, but 2 is especially special because it's the only odd prime, and it ruins the most equations, so to speak. Going further here, if you search the question on the internet, there's actually relatively little that talks especially about characteristic 2, about this exception. There is one stack exchange question if you want to get see some perspectives or elaborations on that. You can browse for that. This question also refers to this math overflow question. there are some high level and some lower level answers. In reality, the also the higher level answers boil down to the simple fact that if 1 plus 1 is 0, then 1 is minus 1. So this basically takes away the minus. And plus and minus is the same thing. And your arithmetic becomes quite trivial. What I want to show in the video is just some examples of these kind of fields of characteristic 2. The simplest one would be the finite simple group of order 2, so a field with just 2 elements. If you have a prime number like 2, 3, 5, 7 and so on, then the modular arithmetic over that is a field, and you can do like field theory. And the finite field of order 2, the 2 element field, right, this is like close to Boolean algebra, is such an example, such a field where the arithmetic is very simple. But there are also other fields of characteristic 2. And as it turns out, these fields are exactly those which have 2 to the power of some integer, to the power of some natural number amount of elements. Okay, so I already mentioned the integer modulo n. Here, if n is 2, then you have a characteristic 2 field. But also, this is not actually a field, but there's this nice, funny Wikipedia article on the field with 1 element. So I emphasize it's not a field because the field axioms don't work out, but there is a bunch of formulas of general field theory which also work for if you set n equals to 1. And this article discusses the idea. So this is the the smallest case, which doesn't even make a field. Then you have the field of order 2, which is field of characteristic 2. And then you have this Wikipedia article on the finite fields. And this is actually one that I usually just use the Wikipedia articles just as a template to guarantee people, hey, this topic exists, and here you might find some information reference. But this finite field article is actually pretty good. It's quite long and discusses like various examples. So I like that one. This one gives another example of a field of characteristic 2, and this is the finite field with 4 elements, right? So 4 is not a prime number. So if you look at the modular arithmetic with modulo 4, then this doesn't behave as nicely as modulo 3 or modulo 5, where you can always find the inverses. But nonetheless, if you look at the field with 4 elements and addition, multiplication and division defined like that, you know, you can try that out. The rules from a polynomial arithmetic perspective is that you look at polynomials with coefficient in the field with 2 elements. And whenever x squares pops up, you replace it with minus x minus 1. So this is basically how you represent this field with in polynomial rings. Not going to any definitional details here, but here you have how you do take these 4 elements and define addition and so on and so forth. So you see that this is a field because for every element except for 0 here, you find an inverse. So for example, if you multiply 1 plus x or 1 plus alpha here with alpha, then you get alpha plus alpha squared, and alpha squared can be reduced with this thing. And then you end up with 1. So this is a perfectly nice field, even if it's kind of strange because it only has 4 elements and it has surprising, let's say, multiplication rules. But the point is that this is a field where if you look at the addition, if you add anything to itself, 0 plus 0 is 2, 0, it's of course 0. But also 1 plus 1 is 2, which is also equals to 0 according to this addition table, and x plus x is 2x, and since 2 is 0, this is 0, and similarly for 1 plus x. So here you have a field, just four elements. You have a nice arithmetic, but the characteristic is two. So it's actually a very, like, in a sense, trivial field. And you cannot even write down 2x, or you can write it down, but 2x just represents zero. So this, like, reduces a bunch of formulas to something trivial. And that makes problems if you want to, you know, take any, if you do an Lie algebras and write down, oh, here's the commutator, you know, x times y minus y times x, but this is a field of characteristic two, then minus is the same as plus, and you get a bunch of identities, or your axioms just reduced to tautologies because everything breaks down. And so this special case of these fields with characteristic two are treated separately. What do I still want to say? You're here, I'm back to the, I'm here in the finite field Wikipedia article, and then there is one section on Frobenius automorphisms, or I think if we go back actually to the field Wikipedia article, then there's also a short section on characteristic. Then there's also this example with four elements. And if I'm not confused, then they also speak about the Frobenius map. So the point is this, that if, you know, take any field or ring with characteristic two and consider x plus y to the power, like in brackets, to the power of two. Well, x plus y to the power of two is just x squared plus 2xy plus y squared, right? But if the characteristic of the field is two, then this, the middle term, 2xy, is just zero. So what you get is a case where the exponentiation distributes over the individual elements, right? And that then makes the exponentiation to this particular power into an automorphism, right? It preserves the field structure. And then there's a whole theory about these kind of maps. And especially for a field with characteristic two, that means, because the two is such a low number, that you even have this kind of special property already for two. So, you know, in these fields, minus x is the same as x, so there's no sign theory. Basically, the plus and minus is the same, and also just taking the square of anything already, like, is already an automorphism. So this is quite special among, like, other fields. Then, of course, you know, a field of characteristic three might also have some special relations. Every characteristic has some speciality to it, but two just pops up so easily that it ruins more, you can say. Yeah, there's also then related to this, there's this funny name, Freshman's Dream, where you have this rule, like, x plus y to the power of n is x squared plus y squared. And the joke kind of is that there are, like, mathematical objects where this is really the case. I think this article also, yeah, discusses some history or why that's interesting. Okay, but I'm not going to do any nice arithmetic in this video. I'm just pointing to things that you might want to read, for example, this Wikipedia page, and better take a book and actually read in a textbook kind of fashion. Okay, so I hope this kind of emphasized what is really special. So if you don't want that plus x is minus x, if you don't want your formulas ruined by that, then you talk about vector spaces and exclude these finite fields with 2 to the power of n elements, because those are those which have characteristic of 2. Actually, if you have a finite field of with the number of elements being some prime number to the power of some natural number, then the characteristic is this prime number. And this is particularly brutal for p equals 2. So that was it for that video, really. of course, subscribe to this channel if you want me, if you want to know more about Lie algebras, where I will get to. And also in 1 week from now, I will be in Santa Monica, California. So if you happen to be from there, I'm there for 1 week, then let me know, and maybe we talk about math and physics over a coffee or something like that. Okay, take care.